are playing on area screens this weekend.
Here to tell us about The Revenant and The Hateful Eight, film critic Chuck Kaplinsky. The Revenant, is this the one with
Yeah, him. The guy
I remember from the Big Ship movie.
That's the guy, yeah, Leonardo DiCaprio. Apparently, Mr. DiCaprio and everyone else in this movie suffered a great deal while making this movie. This was shot in Calgary, and the director insisted on using natural light throughout the film, which gives us a nice overcast, a nice dark pall. It's a gorgeous film, absolutely gorgeous film to look at. DiCaprio plays a guy by the name of Hugh Glass, and this is based on a true story. Apparently, this guy was a scout, and he was out trapping with the Rocky Mountain Fur Company when he was mauled by a bear. Mauled by a bear to the extent to where his lung was punctured, his scalp was half torn off, he had numerous gouges and throughout his body, and was left in very rough shape. And we do see this bear mauling in full display about 20 minutes into the film. Two guys are left behind to help him, but they end up abandoning him, leaving him for dead. And as the true story goes, Mr. Glass was able to crawl back to the nearby river that was about 20 miles away and float back to the fort where he had come. Estimates are anywhere that this was a trip of 80 to anywhere from 200 miles,
depending on
the tall tale that you believe. Here you see Tom Hardy as the guy who does leave him behind, and you can see that the DiCaprio character is haunted by the death of his wife as well as his young son. This is a gorgeous film, as I say, and it's one that needs to be seen on a big screen to really appreciate the visuals and to really give you a sense of the wilderness, as well as the isolation that these characters suffer from, which of course affects how they act and behave with each other. DiCaprio's performance is very physical. I think I would be surprised if he had more than 12 lines of dialogue in the entire thing. However, he is conveying a great deal of pain, most emotionally and physically throughout. He is fantastic. The film does run out of steam at the end. It runs 2.5 hours. Had it been about 20 minutes less, I think it would have been better. But overall, a movie that attempts a great deal and accomplishes most of it, one I highly recommend.
What was the one that he was in 2015 where he also played another dynamic character, like The Wolf of Wall Street is the one that I'm thinking.
Wolf of Wall Street, right.
He seems to pick those kinds of roles where you're taking a very memorable character.
He likes to challenge himself, you know, and I think that that comes from working with Martin Scorsese. His roles, his movies deal with extreme characters as well, and I think he's got, you know, DiCaprio is one of our best actors, so I think he gets bored easily, and he's always looking for a challenge.
Okay, so talking about those extreme characters, do we have a few in Hateful